This here's a true story about crossing the pond at night in the world's smallest cockpit on the tanker through the weather. Oh, and to the tanker crew who did that, thanks a lot. We really appreciated that. I'm just kidding. No, I'm not. Well, there I was, crossing the pond, and you could see that I wasn't exactly fond of all the shit I was wearing on that day. Now an F-16 is cramped enough, but it's even worse with all that stuff supposed to save your life. But we knew there was no way. 'Cause when you're going down the North Atlantic, man, it's over. Now about 4 hours into the flight, well, I got a little nervous 'cause it was still night. I'm on the wing of the tanker, man, and I got a piss. So I started fucking with the jaws of death, and before I knew it, well, I was out of breath, pissed off a cursing and saying to hell with this. And I seriously considered just pissing my pants. So finally got the fly undone, and I knew the next part would be twice as fun, trying to get the gopher to pop on out of his hole. So I thought real hard about naked chicks, lesbians and porno flicks, but none of that worked 'cause he knew that water was damn cold. And I cursed my daddy's name for making me half Polish. Well, I knew that I would need a little help to keep from pissing all over myself, and if I held it any longer, well, I'd give myself cancer. So in my hour of great despair, well, I offered up a simple prayer to Jesus, hoping that he might answer. And to paraphrase a bit, this is what I said. Dear Lord, won't you give me a 12-inch penis just for an hour or two? I'm stuck in the trenches, and I need just a few more inches, and I'll give them back as soon as I am through. Now my faith was strong, but my strength was lacking, and I didn't have much time for this miracle to happen, so I thought the best thing to do was just help it along. So I started to pull and it started to pinch, and I thought I might have squeezed out an extra inch, but that sucker was wedged in tighter than your grandma's thong. Yeah, folks, I'm sorry, that was completely uncalled for. So I choked that fucker like a serial killer, made me think about that movie, you know, the one with Ben Stiller, where the dude in the back was yelling, he was masturbating. Now with the other hand I reached for the bag, and I tried to take aim, but it was just a wag, and I knew my chances of success, they were quickly fading. And at this point I knew it would take an act of desperation. Now it was too much to hope I could get it to dangle, well, the best I could do was a 90 degree angle and hookshot that son of a bitch like Dr. J. Now I never really thought about what was ensuing till I realized I couldn't see what the fuck I was doing, and I paused for a second and I began to pray. Dear Lord, you gotta give me this one. Dear Lord, won't you give me a 12-inch penis just for an hour or two? Trenches, and I need just a few more inches, and I'll give them back as soon as I am through. Now just about the time I started to go, well, old Mr. Winky, he started to grow, and before I knew it, he was at least a foot long. Now up in heaven, God got quite a laugh, 'cause it kept on going past a foot and a half, and before I knew it, I was holding the 2-foot schlong. Now I know what you're thinking, what the hell's he gonna do with that? Well, that was pretty much the end of my woes, since now I had a Johnson like a fire hose. In fact, the whole problem was completely diffused. Now what I did next, you might think sleazy, but at this point, pissing was just too easy. And my newfound powers, well, they just had to be used. You know, for fighting the forces of evil and shit. Now when it was my turn to refuel, well, I thought it would be pretty fucking cool if I did the whole thing with my hands behind my back. Now you might think that was the ultimate test, but the hardest part was really the ILS, 'cause I thought about your mom and I ended up well off track. Yeah, slightly above glide slope and climbing. Now after I landed, that was the trick, 'cause what the hell do you do with 2 feet of dick? But it didn't matter much, 'cause the Lord, he came to relieve me. 'Cause when I tried to put it all back in the cup, well, it looked like my 2 hours were up. And I thought to myself, well, who the hell will believe me? Well, you can bet for damn sure it ain't gonna be my wife. Dear Lord, won't you give me a 12-inch penis just for an hour or two? I'm stuck in the trenches and I need just a few more inches, and I'll give them back as soon as I am through. Yeah, I'll give them back as soon as I am through.